Hello students, last time we have explained about the procurement of honeybee colonies and hiving the bee colonies while the successful practice or the commercial practice of the beekeeping. Now today we will explain the next point, that is seasonal management. Seasonal variations adversely affect the bee colonies. So the environmental factors such as temperature or presence or absence of adequate quantity or good quality of the flora for the feeding of the bees as a source of nectar and pollen. So this leads to the variations during the different seasons of the year, and which will adversely affect the honeybee colonies. So seasonal variations with respect to change of the conditions, that is environmental factors or the flora present in the particular region, adversely affecting the bee colonies. And thus commercial beekeepers should manage the bee colonies in each season for better protection, gathering the honey flow, and to prevent the swarming instinct or the character, following your season wise practices for bee colonies. So due to the seasonal variations of the year or the climatic conditions, weather conditions which can become unfavorable or adverse type, and this will affect the health of bees, or this will lead to adverse effect onto the honeybee colonies, and hence commercial beekeeper have to manage the bee colonies properly in each season for the better protection, gathering or collection of honey flow period, that is a complete exhaust of food source, that is pollen or nectar, should be collected by the bees during the honey flow period, and to prevent the swarming instinct. So during unfavorable conditions, the honeybee colonies may leave the hive box, and this will lead to the desertation of the hives. So it is very essential to beekeeper to take proper care of the bees so as to prevent the swarming or absconding behavior of the honeybee colonies or the character. So there are season wise practices must be practiced by the beekeeper. So first we'll explain the rainy season management. Rainy season changes the climatic parameters like high humidity and temperature. So during rainy season, there is a high humidity in the environment, or temperature is also high, and these conditions leads to the restless nature, lethargic nature in the bees, and they suffer from dysentery. Honey in the uncapped cells undergo fermentation, and stored pollen grain becomes moldy or having fungal infections, and forager bees, or the bees which are involved in the actual collection of nectar and pollen, cannot go out of the hive due to the heavy rains. And such situations require artificial feeding, that is a candy or a dry sugar and fat-free soybean flour as a substitute for the pollen grains, and keep the colonies in a ventilated areas with a continuous inspection of the colonies. So these are the some of the activities should be practiced during the rainy season for the taking proper care of the honeybee colonies. So rainy season changes the climatic parameters, that leads to high humidity and the temperature, and this leads to the restless condition or lethargic nature in the bees, and honeybees may serve or suffer from the protozoan disease or the Nosema disease, or leading into the symptoms of the dysentery, or honey in the uncapped cells undergoing fermentation, or the stored pollen grains become moldy due to the fungal attack or the infestation, and forager bees cannot go out of the hive due to the heavy rains. So large quantity or large number of bees, worker bees, remains in the hive due to the heavy rains, and thus this type of situation requires, in such a situation require artificial feeding. In such situation requires artificial or excess feeding, that is in the form of candy or dry sugar and the fat free soybean flour as a substitute for the pollen grains, and keep the colonies in the well ventilated areas with a continuous inspection of the colonies. So these are the some of the measures can be practiced during the rainy season. Then next is winter management. Honeybee requires moderate temperature. If the temperature is raised or increased beyond 33.5 degree centigrade, they cool their nest, and if the temperature below 10 degree centigrade, the bees produce heat by the muscular movements by consuming more of the honey. And thus, if their nests are insulated, then the honey consumption will be reduced and it saves the energy of the bees. And for this purpose, the 4-inch thick insulation of the gunny bags on all the 6 sides of the hive or the bee box is generally done for the 4 months, that is from November to February, that is during the winter, which will protect the hive from severe cold and the frosty mornings. So during winter season, these are the measures or the practices should be practiced or should be done so as to protect the bees during the severe cold or the frosty winter month. So during winter management, we know the bee require the moderate temperature, and if the temperature is increased beyond the 33.5 degree centigrade, the honeybee themselves cool their nest either by fanning activity or by putting the drop of the water in the hive so as to maintain the normal temperature or the moderate temperature in the hive during the increased temperature. And if the temperature is below 10 degree centigrade during winters, honeybees produce heat by the muscular movements by consuming much of the honey, and thus if their nest or the hive box are insulated, then honey consumption will be reduced and it saves the energy of the bees. And for this purpose, a 4-inch thick insulation of gunny cloth or gunny bags on all 6 sides of the hive box generally done, and for this is done for the period of 4 months, that is November to February or the season of the winter, which protects the hive from severe cold and frosty mornings. Then thirdly, the spring management. After overwintering, so or after the end of winter and at the beginning of the spring, the colonies should be inspected, because the onset of the spring honey flow, honeybees goes all out to rear a brood and to increase its strength or the population. So more of the sugar syrup should be given, and drawn combs or the frames must be added next to the brood frames. So during spring season, after overwintering or after end of the winter or at the time of spring, the colonies should be inspected, because that is the spring is the onset or the beginning of the honey flow period, and during which all the honeybees goes out of the hive to collect the nectar and pollen from the honey flow of the spring month. And thus, it is essential to increase the strength or the population of the bees, or it is essential to provide them गुड एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए फूड और ए शुगर सायरप एंड दैट शुड बी गिवन टू द बीज ड्यूरिंग द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द स्प्रिंग सीजन एंड फॉर दिस पर्पज द drawn crumbs must be added next to the brood frames. So brood frames and the drawn combs with a sugar syrup can be kept in the brood box so as to provide the adequate feed in the form of sugar syrup so as to increase the strength or the population of the honeybees or so as to increase the number of the bees in the colony so as to increase the strength of the bees for the collection of the nectar and pollen of the spring honey flow. So this is the measures which should be performed by the beekeeper during the spring season. Or replace the queen with a young active one if old queen is not working satisfactorily. So during spring management, the one more activity that could also be practiced, that is the replacement of the new queen in the colony, so that the all activities of the colony could be managed properly by the new young vigorous or the active queen, and thus the old queen can be replaced by new young active queen in the colony during the spring season, so that she could secrete or she could produce a large quantity of queen substance that could help to maintain all activities of the honeybee colony so as to exhaust or so as to collect the large quantity of nectar and pollen of the honey flow period of the spring. Then lastly, the summer management. The spring honey flow is followed by a summer. So after the spring season, there is a beginning of the summer. So the spring honey flow is followed by a summer. The dearth period in all localities, the dearth period in all localities appears, and during this period, the honey is extracted from the combs. So at the end of the spring honey flow, the honey from the comb is extracted by the beekeeper, and just after which there is a beginning of the dearth period or the drought conditions, that is the lack of absence of adequate flowering plant vegetation during this summer, and this become this will lead to broodless condition in the hive, and this leads to decrease in number of workers is called as thinning of the workers. Besides these changes, the enemy's destructive activities become increased, and it results into stopping the egg laying by the queen. So during the summer month, there is a beginning of the dearth period. Honey from the frames is also extracted at the end of the spring flow. So there is dearth condition or drought condition in the hive. This results into broodlessness. The workers might have left the colonies or might have died in a much of the number, and this will lead to the thinning of the workers. Besides these changes, the destructive activity of the enemies also increased, or this will result into the stopping of the egg laying by the queen. So during this critical period, the beekeeper should manage the bee colonies to avoid broodlessness. So beekeeper has to take proper care, that is the provision of proper feeding, cleaning, watering, so that the queen bee could lay the eggs in the brood chamber or in the hive or in the comb, and this will result into broodlessness condition. So this will ultimately prevent the broodlessness in the hive, or the queen bee could lay the egg and can continue its reproductive activities. So during this critical period, the beekeeper should manage the colonies to avoid broodlessness and initiate them to rear the brood. So all activities should be provided optimally in the hive so that the broodlessness will be avoided and the young or active or vigorous queen could be maintained in the colony so that she could lay the egg and can rear the brood. It is done by maintaining strong colonies with a young vigorous queen, and the colonies should be kept in a cool, shady and protected places. So during summer month, the bee boxes should be kept under the trees in a cool condition or in the shed or in the protected place so that the queen bee could rear a brood or young ones in the colony so as to avoid the broodlessness. And for this purpose, maintenance of strong colonies with a young, vigorous or active queen is essential, and honeybee colonies should be kept in the cool, shady and protected places. To summarize the above, means all the seasonal management, to summarize the above, that is rainy season management, winter management, spring management. Rainy season management, winter management, spring management, or the summer management. To summarize the practices or the efforts or the measures above, the proper management of beekeeping program, the following precautions should be taken. So to summarize the seasonal managements of all four seasons, that is rainy season, winter season, spring season and the summer management, there should be some precautionary measures or a minimum management program, minimum management beekeeping program should be followed with some common precautions or the measures, and they are: the hive should not be kept more than half a mile away from the place from where the bees have to collect the nectar and pollen. So very important point for beekeeping or a successful or commercial practice of beekeeping, that is the hive boxes or the apiary place should not be much away or more than half a mile away from the place of apiary or a place of feeding, that is flowering plant vegetation, that is suitable for collection of nectar and pollen. So the hive should not be kept more than half a mile away from the place from where the bees have to collect the nectar and pollen, that is the site of apiary, and the feeding place should not be more than half a mile away from one another. Secondly, a proper watch on the activities of the bees. So proper inspection or the regular inspection of the bees is essential so as to maintain the healthy, disease-free or hygienic conditions, proper feeding of the honeybees. So proper watch on the activities of the bees is also essential. Strong colony can be developed by providing sugar syrup, pollen substitute to the honeybees. So supplement feeding or additional feeding in the form of sugar syrup and the fat-free soybean flour as a substitute of the pollen should be provided to the bees so as to maintain the strong colony. And this can be done by providing adequate quantity of the sugar syrup and the pollen substitute, that is a fat-free soybean flour, to the honeybees. Then under adverse climatic conditions, the hive can be transferred from one place to the other for the protection of the bees. So during adverse conditions of the particular region, the hive boxes should be transported or transferred to the place where there could be a proper protection of the honeybees. There could be a proper protection of the bees. So under adverse climatic conditions, the hive boxes can be transferred from one place to the other where the protection of the bees will occur easily. And finally, the combs can be protected from the enemies, etc. The combs or the honeybee colonies can be protected from the bee enemies, etc. So these are the some important points or the measures, and this should be considered or practiced to summarize the seasonal managements. So to summarize the seasonal management, these are the essential points, or the these points or these measures should be practiced during the commercial practice of the beekeeping. So this is what about the seasonal management. So today with this we'll stop here, and next time we'll continue the next point, that is bee products. So today we'll stop here. Thank you.